Here's an amazing node in Houdini 19. Let's jump in together and check it out.
Vellum Brush. This node is not new to Houdini 19, but they introduced some really nice features like being able to brush fluids and grains. This is a really fun node to use and gives great flexibility. You are able to brush any of the Vellum constraints. Soft bodies, hair, fluid, grains, cloth, it all works and it's so much fun. So let's jump into Houdini and check it out. Let's first take a look at some of the key settings in the Vellum Brush. Here, just have a grid. I've set its size to 2x2. And I've given it 2x2 rows and columns. I'm then remeshing it with a value of 0.02 so that we get a fairly high resolution mesh. I then need to configure some sort of Vellum constraint. So we'll use Vellum Cloth. I'll leave all the values at default. Lastly, let's drop a Vellum Brush. Let's hit enter so we jump into brush mode. It may take a couple seconds to compile OpenCL. Then we're ready to brush. And here are some of the brush shapes. Screen is the default and it'll brush through world space, anything that's in front or behind your brush. This is great. But when working in 3D, it can often affect parts of your mesh that you may not want to. So in those cases, I usually switch to volume if not using screen. There are other brush modes, but I find screen and volume give me the results I want 90% of the time. You can cycle between the brushes by hitting B. There are also different brush modes. You can right click to find them, or you can use your number keys. Brush mode pushes geometry in the direction of your brush, like you're running your finger over a piece of cloth. Drag will move your geometry in the direction of your brush, like pinching a section of cloth and pulling it. Contract expand. You can switch between these two by holding Ctrl and clicking, or just normal clicking. Contract pinches the cloth towards the brush. Expand does the opposite. It pushes the cloth away, much like ironing out wrinkles. Rotate spins points around the brush's center. You can hold Ctrl to change the direction. Crease and ruffle shrinks the cloth or expands us. This is the same as affecting rest length in a normal simulation, except here we can paint it in. You can also stipulate the intensity of this in the brush settings, which is also super useful. The last brush mode is collisions. This is really useful when you have a nice simulation, but you have some collisions. You can paint the areas of collision, and the Vellum Brush will try and solve these areas and leave the rest of your simulation alone. Once there are no collisions detected, it will release these pins. In the quality setting, you can always increase your substeps to help the Vellum Brush prevent intersections. In the collisions tab, you can enable a ground plane, but you can also set external collisions. By default, it is set to polygon. However, dense volume will convert your polygonal mesh into a volume collider, which is often faster and more accurate to solve. We'll use that throughout this video. The final section to talk through is the forces tab. By default, this is set to damped. Damped and settled are the same, except they have different force settings. Settled has less velocity damping and has live simulation on by default, so you get a simulation closer to that of a Vellum solver. Damped is more static with a lot of velocity damping, so you get something a lot easier to paint and art direct. You can obviously switch between the two. I often find myself jumping between them. I like to start with settled and then switch to damped and brush in some of my finer details. As this node is all live, it's much harder to showcase, but here are some quick walkthroughs. Because the Vellum Brush is essentially a Vellum solver at its core, we can also do things like welding points and attaching them. So here I have Tommy, but he's naked, so let's fix that. So I start with a tube, and I'll ray this onto Tommy using a maximum distance. I'll then use another tube, and this will be the skirt. Now we'll create a cloth constraint. Then we'll create a weld constraint and select the groups that I created above. This will weld my skirt to my waistband. We'll then use a Vellum attach to attach the waistband to Tommy. Now we can attach a Vellum brush. Now I'll hit G to enable the settled mode and you'll see that all my constraints are taken into effect. However, my skirt is a little bit poofy and I'd like to settle it down and have a few more folds. So let's hit G again and go back into damped mode and paint in those folds. Now I can art direct exactly what I want the skirt to look like. Once it's finalized, I can hit the set rest state button and it'll save my current state into the Vellum brush. So now I can use this in another simulation if I want. It's also a lot of fun to point deform our original mesh onto the points from a Vellum fluid. We can now brush our Vellum fluid while point deforming to get some really strange and fun results. Again, switching between simulation modes gets some really cool interaction and results. There's no limitation on what you can feed the Vellum brush, so you can also feed in both Vellum soft bodies and Vellum fluid and brush them both at the same time. As with normal simulations, you can merge your geometry streams and your constraint streams and feed them into the Vellum brush. This lets you get some really great results. Now that we've had a brief overview of all the tools in the Vellum brush, let's take a look at using it on something more useful like a sofa. So in this scene, I created a procedural sofa without any expressions. If you're curious about how that can be set up, have a look at the match size video in this series. It's an amazing node that got some awesome upgrades in Houdini 19. I created these base cushions using the Vellum brush. We'll use the same technique to create some back pillows. So let's dive in. All right, so here in my scene, we have the sofa, we have these two pillows, and now we're going to create another pillow for this backrest. So I start with the box, and I'm object merging in the backrest of my sofa. I'm then using a match size to put it in the place that I want it for my overall sofa, which we can template over here. I'm using the match size, and if you want to see this, you can see my other tutorial on the match size to see how this is working. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to poly split it, which just allows me to cut in some additional edges. I'm then going to subdivide it to get the base shape of my pillow. On the right hand stream, I'm using a polypath from my box to create this wireframe. I'll turn the point mode on. I can then resample it to give it some extra points. I'm going to fuse those points and then I'm going to subdivide. I'll then resample this with smooth subdivision turned on. And if I template my pillow, you can see that I have this mesh around the outside. I will then ray this mesh onto my pillow. And then I'll create edge groups with this. And if I put down a blast node, and we select this group, you can see that this is the edge group that I've created. I'm going to use this group to shrink these sections of the pillow and then expand the rest to give it a nice fluffy look. I'm then bringing in my sofa as a collider, creating a vellum cloth. And the vellum cloth, I've given it 1 million times 6 stretch. And the bend stiffness is set to default. And then I'm using a vellum pressure with 6,000 and a rest length scale of 10 so that it should expand. I'm then promoting this group that I've created here, as you can see it, onto primitives. I'm then transferring it onto my constraint geometry. And then I'm setting my rest length on just this group to be 0.9. Well, multiplied by 0.9 so that these areas will shrink. And then because the pressure is set to 10, these areas will expand. Now, when I jump into the Vellum brush and I hit G to simulate, you can see now I've got this nice fluffy pillow where it's shrinking in these certain areas and it's expanded in every other area. Let's just get rid of this template flag, jump back here. And now what I can do is I can actually move my pillow around and I can place it however I like. And I want it to just be lying down a little bit more. And obviously I can use my other brush modes such as crease or ruffle and change this to damped mode. And I could, for instance, just paint in some additional creasing if I wanted to. Let's just say that that is what I wanted. Maybe not. So let's go back into G and it'll just expand a little bit, hit G again. And so now I've got my pillow. I'm going to set the rest state. And then for now, let's just do a transform and copy the same pillow again, and I'm merging this with my sofa. So now I've got two and we can maybe even squeeze in a third one and we'll just rotate it over. Ideally, we would simulate these all separately so that they're all different. But for now, we'll just do it like this. The next thing I want to do is I want to add some cloth and drape it over. So if we have a look at this final one, this is something like we want to do. So I'm just going to go to my vellum brush and I'm going to reset all changes. So here I've created a grid. Again, it's 2x2 columns and rows, and I've set a size as 2.7 and 1. I'm then remeshing it to get some really nice triangles. I'm also upping the iterations of the smoothing, because when it's set to the default 2, you get these really weird triangles. With a value of 10, they're really nice and uniform. I can then transform my cloth all the way up above my sofa. I then create a cloth constraint and a vellum brush, and now we can simulate. Now I can check I'm on screen and I'm on drag, and I can just slowly drag. And here you can see that I've increased my velocity damping and static friction so that it sticks a little bit more. I'm actually going to reduce this down to 1. Now we can just pull our cloth around as we want. And we just make some nice slow movements to get some nice draping cloth over our sofa. So when we're happy, we can hit G again and freeze our simulation. Now we have this really cool draped cloth and sofa that looks really great. All in all, this note has a ton of cool uses and has a lot of flexibility with the different modes and features. The help documentation is also really helpful and thorough, so be sure to check that out. I'd love to see what you create using this note. So it's time to open Houdini, dive inside, and make something awesome.